So let us quickly start with the first speaker. I have already posted the rules of today's session in the chat. If anybody doesn't follow these rules, then your points will be cut. So today's first speaker is Arush Shetty.
Anya, I think the rules are not there. You have posted it to me. Just check if it's for everyone or for me.
I can see the rules.
We can see the rules.
Okay.
So we can start with Arush.
Pranam to all Atma Jyotis. My name is Arush Shetty from Balakrishna Group. Today I'm going to speak about Sri Adi Shankaracharya, the greatest Acharya of Hinduism. Long back, people in India had lost their spiritual values. So all the devatas went to Shiva and prayed for the people. They expressed their concern that people had lost their spirituality. So Shivji told, I will take avatar, incarnation, and teach spirituality to the world. There lived a couple by name Shivaguru and Aryambal in Kaladi in Kerala. They were devotees of Shiva and were worshipping him. One day, Shiva came to Aryambal's dream and told, I will be your son to teach Dharma and Jnana to the whole world. After some time, she gave birth to a boy child. The boy was a bright child, and their parents did Upanayanam at the age of 5, and he started going to Gurukula. One day he went to a house begging for food. There lived an old lady in that house. The old lady was very poor. She didn't have anything to eat except an amla fruit. She gave that to Shankara. So, seeing her poverty, Shankara feels compassionate and prays for Ma Mahalakshmi, the goddess of wealth. He started his prayers and composed the Kanakadhara mantra. Totra, and Ma Mahalakshmi was very pleased and poured golden gooseberry rain in the old lady's house. From this, the poverty was banished. Due to some disease, Shankara's father died. At the age of 8, he had completed his entire education and was very good at it. He mastered all the 4 Vedas, Bhagavad Gita, Upanishads, and everything. He also remembered it very well. He also had the desire to take up sannyas. But his mother was worried that if he takes up the sannyasa, who will take care of her? So, one day, he was praying in a river, nearby river. A crocodile caught his leg and started pulling. He screamed and called his mother and told her to pray for his life. He told that if the crocodile lets go, you have to agree me taking up sannyas. The mother agreed and the crocodile let go. After some time, he left home and goes in search of his guru. He wandered. One day, he reached Narmada, but the Narmada river was overflowing due to floods. But he wanted to go to the other side to meet Guru Govindapada. So he prayed for Narmada River to calm down. After some time, Narmada River calmed down. So he swims and goes to the other side of the lake and meets his Guru Govindapada. And the Guru taught him that Advaita. He accepted as he also accepted him as a student. At the age of 16, he wrote commentaries on Upanishads, Bhagavad Gita, and Brahma Sutra. He had many disciples and had visited many places. He also established 4 pithams in Badri, Dwaraka, Puri, and Sringeri. At the age of 32, he established Dharma and he vanished from earth and reached Kailas. I hope you all enjoyed the story of Sri Adi Shankaracharya. Hari Om. Thank you.
Very well done, Arush. You have narrated nicely.
Thank you, ma'am.
Arush, you explained his childhood really well. So before we go to the next speaker, I would like to welcome Katyayani ji on behalf of all the other participants to this speaker session. I also thank Katyayani for her valuable time and her feedback. Next, we have Druti Gupta.
Hari Om everyone, my name is Druti and today I'm going to talk about Adi Shankaracharya ji. Adi Shankaracharya ji was an acharya. He was born to mother Shiv Guru, father Shiv Guru and mother Amya Bhatt. He lived only 32 years in this world. And it is said that in the age of 8, he mastered all 4 Vedas. This is an incident. Incident happened in Adi Shankaracharya's life. Once he went for begging to a house. In that house lived a poor lady. She had only 1 gooseberry. That too for eating for herself. She saw Adi Shankaracharya ji and gave him that gooseberry. Adi Shankaracharya ji was so pleased with her kindness that he prayed to Goddess Lakshmi. Goddess Lakshmi was so pleased with his one prayer that she rained gold gooseberries. And in the age of 16, he wrote a commentary on the great Brahma Sutra. And in the age of 12, he completed all the studies and scriptures at that time. In the age of 32, he completed his mission. And this is another incident happened in his life. Once Adi Shankaracharya ji asked his mother he wanted to take sannyasa. So he asked his mother. His mother told no. After few days, when Adi Shankaracharya ji was getting ready to bathe in a river, a crocodile came and got hold of his leg. And he started dragging him into the river. Adi Shankaracharya ji called his mother, mother, mother. His mother came running out. What happened? And he told, if you will not let me take sannyasa, this crocodile will drag me into the river and I will die. His mother told, okay. And as soon as she told okay, the crocodile opened his mouth and Adi Shankaracharya ji's leg was freed. And he took the blessings of his mother and took sannyasa and became a monk. I will sum up say that it's difficult to understand the vision presented before us by Adi Shankaracharya ji. But if we understand it, we are blessed. Thank you. Hari Om.
Good, Druti. Well done, well done.
Thank you, ma'am.
Great job, Druti. You explained the crocodile incidents very well. Next, we have Harsh Jain.
My pranams to all Atma Jyotis, the divine light of the self. My name is Harsh Jain. Do you know that corruption in India causes loss of growth in terms of investment and employment by rupees 25,000 crores. So, shouldn't we try to make India a corruption-free country? So, let us learn more about this corruption. By corruption, I mean that any dishonest or immoral behavior that results in the gain of some powerful organization of people. Thus, corruption often results in the loss of the lower section in the society. One of the major causes of corruption is human nature itself. We are attracted to luxurious lives and often go beyond our affordability. Our educational system only focuses on educational excellence. It doesn't focus on values, which is also very important in our life. Another cause which always remains latent and slowly sows the seed of bribery is our parents, teachers, and elders who tell us to score good marks by giving us a bribe, a bicycle. If you tell your children to score good marks by giving you a bicycle, how do you expect them to do something selflessly for the nation? So now let me talk about one of the effects of corruption. Children are becoming very selfish due to corruption and bribery. Children and parents and people are dying in villages due to not having money to buy the food they need. So their food and milk should be given freely to the poor. Even children are not getting education, so it should also be given freely to the villages and people who can't afford the money they need for the schools. Now, let us talk about how to make India a corruption-free country. Farmers should be given enough money so that they can buy their land and necessary equipments for farming. As I told you, education should be given freely, because if you miss even one child who can't learn things because of not having money, you might miss out a Chanakya, Einstein or Newton. So every voice holds weight. Evil cannot destroy the system, but watching evil silently shall certainly destroy it. So we should tell people who are doing corruption, not encourage them to do corruption, and also tell them ways to stop doing corruption. Taking bribe is a crime, but so is offering a bribe. So start with yourselves, as charity begins at home. Small steps will make huge impact, and we will certainly make India a corruption-free country. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to talk about corruption. Hari Om.
Very good, Harsh. Many good points you have brought in regarding corruption. But you should imbibe this. Telling is not sufficient. Should know very clearly what you are telling, and you should try to adopt it. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
It was a wonderful talk on corruption, and really nice solutions we all should try to follow. Next, we have Kriti.
Today, I am going to tell the story about Basavanna. Basavanna is a great devotee of Lord Shiva. He has two wives. The first wife's name is Gangambika and the second wife's name is Neelambika. One day, Neelambika went to the Shiva temple for darshan. There, at the same day, the thief's wife also went to Shiva's darshan. There, she saw Neelambika and her beauty. She was standing beauty, and she also saw Neelambika's earrings. They were so nice that she wanted them so badly. Then somehow she did darshan of
Lord Shiva, when she went home, the thief said, serve me food. Then the thief's wife said, bring me the earrings and then I will serve the food. Then the thief said, what are you talking about earrings? What earrings? The thief's wife said, Neelambika's earrings. I want those earrings. Give me them, she said. Then the thief said, do you know who Neelambika is? The wife of Basavanna, our chief minister. Do you know that? The thief's wife said. Then the thief said, I don't know about all that. Just bring me the earrings. The thief, stealing is your dharma. Then the thief decided to go to Basavanna's house. Then Basavanna was serving food for the hungry people. The thief was also hungry, so he went into the house. He put a linga on his chest and then he went inside to eat the food. The food was delicious and he ate. After that, he saw some people going outside and some people putting the shelter on. Then after everybody left, he slowly went into Basavanna's house and went in. Then he saw big lamp glowing. After that, he saw Neelambika's beauty and said, oh, my wife is right. She is very beautiful. Then he slowly unscrewed the earrings and took the earrings. Then he saw the Mangalya. While he was taking out the Mangalya, Neelambika woke up. She screamed. Then Basavanna also woke up and he asked Neelambika, what happened? Then Neelambika said, it's a thief. When Basavanna woke up, he saw the linga on his chest and said to Neelambika, it's Shiva himself. Take out all your ornaments and do namaskara to him, Basavanna said. And Neelambika took all the ornaments off and gave to Basavanna. Basavanna gave to the thief and said, you are Lord Shiva himself. Please take these ornaments. Basavanna said. Then the thief said, no, sir. I am a thief. I am not Lord Shiva. The thief said that. And Basavanna said, no, you are Lord Shiva. Please take them. Then the thief took them and asked Basavanna, thank you, sir. Then Neelambika namaskar to him and Basavanna told him that you can be the king's security. Then after that, the thief was living a happy life. Hari Om.
Good, Priti. See how Mahatmas, na? Their one word will transform the people. Isn't it? So always you should listen to the stories of Mahatmas, read the stories of Mahatmas. Okay. Good.
Wonderful narration, Kriti. We have Meeral on the list next. Meeral, could you please start?
Hello. Hari Om. I am B. Meeral. Today I am going to tell you a story about Basavanna. Basavanna has two wives. First wife name is Gangambika and second wife name is Neelambika. And Neelambika went to the Shiva temple. At the same day, thief's wife went to the Shiva temple. Thief's wife saw Nilambika and said, "Wow, what a beauty." Then she was jealous by that beauty. Then she saw the earrings of Nilambika. Then she wanted the earrings of Nilambika, but somehow she done the darshan of Lord Shiva. Then she went back home, and thief said, I want food, serve me food." Then the thief's wife said, "No, I want earrings." "Whose earrings? Which earrings?" "Nilambika's earrings." "Do you know who is Nilambika? She is the wife of the chief minister." That's one now. Then they told. Then the thief told, "I can't rob the earrings of Nilambika." "But you are a thief. It's your dharma," said thief's wife. Then thief went to Baswana's house. There he saw Baswana was giving food for hungry people, but there was only one rule: they should have a linga on their chest. Then he took a cloth and a stone, make a linga on his chest. He went inside, and he was hungry, and he ate food. It was so delicious. Then some people were going outside, and some people were making shelter for the night. Then Baswana, then thief found a shelter, and at the night everyone was slept. Then he went to Baswana's house, and then he saw Nilambika and unscrewed the earrings of Nilambika. Then he saw the Mangalya. He wanted a Mangalya. He was taking off the Mangalya. Then Nilambika woke up. Then she screamed. Then Baswana woke up and said, "What happened?" Thief, said Nilambika. But Baswana said, "He's not a thief. He has linga on his chest. He is Lord Shiva himself." Then Baswana said, "Give all of your ornaments," said to Nilambika. Nilambika removed all the ornaments and gave to the thief. But thief said, "No, no, no, sir, I don't want this." Thief told, "But you are Lord Shiva himself. Please take all this ornament." But the thief said, "No, I am not Lord Shiva, I am thief." But Baswana said, "You should take all these ornaments." Then thief said, "Thank you, sir." Then Baswana said, "Now from tomorrow you are the security guard for the king." Hari Om.
Good, Meeral. Very well done. You have narrated it very nicely.
Thank you, ma'am.
Wonderful narration, Meeral. It was really nice. Next, we have Kritik.
Hari Om. My name is Kritik, and today I'm going to talk about Adi Shankaracharya, the greatest acharya of Hinduism. Adi Shankaracharya was born at Kerala, Kaladi. At the age of 5, his father died. From childhood, he wanted to be a monk. At the age of 5, his father died. And at the age of 7, he went to find his guru. After he found his guru, he learned from the guru, and that's when he was called Adi Shankaracharya. He taught many people all over India, and he made institutes everywhere. But they were only doing rituals. They were only doing rituals. They they were only doing. That's why Adi Shankaracharya said, you are only doing. You haven't understood why are you doing, why are you doing all of this? They were just like copy pasting. So Adi Shankaracharya made all of them understand. All of them understand why they're doing this. And when that's why they became realized. And when they become realized, they are together, and together is called Hinduism. So when everyone are together, that is Hinduism. Before, when they did not understand why they were doing all these rituals, they did not understand like why they're doing all these rituals, for what reason. So that time, what was happening everyone were different. One was poor, one was rich, one was that, one was this. So that's not same. I'm poor, you're rich. That's not called same. So that's why, and that's not Hinduism. So he fixed that thing, and that's when everyone saw I and you are the same. I am God, you and you are God. That's same, and that's called Hinduism. Hari Om, thank you.
Wonderful, Kithik. You gave very good example of copy paste. I will remember it always. Very nice example. And about Hinduism,
like, you and I do it sometimes.
Yeah. About Hinduism also, you gave a nice explanation. Wonderful.
Thank you.
That was really nice, Kritik. Thanks for mentioning the real significance of the Hindu rituals and the deep meanings hidden in them. Next speaker is Purna.
Hari Om to Atma Jyotis. I am Purna from Balakrishna team. Today I would like to talk about Adi Shankaracharya, reformer of Hinduism. Adi Shankaracharya, the great philosopher, was born in 788 CE in Kaladi, present in Kerala. He died in 820 at the early age of 32 in Kedarnath, present in Uttarakhand. He actually did not die in the age of 32, but he disappeared in Kedarnath, and people assume that he was dead. Shankaracharya was a noted philosopher and theologizer from India. Adiguru Shankaracharya's early days. Adi Shankaracharya was born to Nambudari Brahmana couple, Shivaguru and Aryamba, in a small village called Kaladi in Kerala. The couple had remained childless for a long time and prayed to Lord Shiva for a child. Lord Shiva appeared in a dream and promised her that he would incarnate as her child. Thus, Lord Shiva incarnated as a boy and was born to Aryamba. Shankaracharya lost his father when he was young. His mother performed his Upanayana ceremonies with the help of his relatives. At the early age, Jagadguru Adi Shankaracharya was very brilliant. He understood the theme of Vedas. He could easily recite Puranas and epics. He wanted to resuscitate the Hindu religion, because in the 8th century, the Hindu religion lost its glory and people were blindly following the Hinduism without knowing the reason. Hindu religion lost its glory by orthodox practices by bigotry people, and the other religions like Buddhism and Jainism were flourishing a lot. Sannyasi and life. Adi, Shank- Adi Shankara wanted his mother to allow him lead a sannyasian life, but his mother denied his thoughts and wanted him to get married. One day, he was taking bath at the Purna River. Suddenly, a crocodile caught him. He called out to his mother, and his mother came running and was shocked seeing the crocodile squeezing him. Then she wanted to rescue him but didn't know how to rescue. Then Shankara called out to his mother and asked her to give him the permission to lead a sannyasian life, or else the crocodile would kill him. She did not want to agree, but she was left with no option other than agreeing on desire of Shankara. So as soon as Shankara left, she agreed, and as soon as Shankara left his home, he went in search of gaining spiritual knowledge. Adi Shankaracharya traveled far and wide in search of a worthy guru. He traveled about 2,000 kilometers in the age of 8 in search of guru who can remove the bigotries and make him the learner of spiritual knowledge. Finally, he reached the bank of Narmada River, and he reached the ashrama of Govinda Bhagavat Pada, the renowned guru and disciple of Gaudapada, who wrote the Mandukya Karikas. Govinda accepted Adi Shankara as his disciple. With the guidance and teaching of Govinda Bhagavat Pada, Jayaguru Adi Shankaracharya attained the spiritual knowledge and also gained the concepts of Jana, Raja, and Hatha Yoga. And then he received the knowledge of Brahma Sutras. After the permission of his guru, Shankaracharya left the ashrama and traveled all over India to spread the Brahma Sutras. He traveled widely within India and participated in public philosophical debates. Shankara defeated orthodox philosophers in the debates and brought reformers in Hinduism. During his journey, he established several mutts and spread the philosophy of Advaita Vedanta. In subsequent, the mutts became the place of Advaita Sutras by his followers. Still, the mutts are running successfully. By this, I would like to end my summary. Thank you. Hari Om.
Well done, Purna. You brought out many, many good points about Shankaracharya.
Thank you, ma'am.
Amazing, Purna. You spoke about how Adi Shankaracharya was the national integrator. Really nice. Next, we have Sanvi Karthik.
Yes, ji. Hari Om. Hari Om. Today, I'm going to talk about Sri Adi Shankaracharya. 2,500 years ago, there were 72 irreligious sects. Dharma and Vedic practices were abused. Brahma, Indra and the rishis prayed to Lord Dakshinamurti to restore peace and save their country from being abused. Meanwhile, on earth, a devout couple, Shivaguru and Aryambal, were praying at a temple at Thrissur for a child. The Lord decided to be born to them as their child. Shankara was born in Kaladi in Kerala. The Devas and Rishis were happy that their prayers had been answered. Shankara became a sannyasi at the age of 8. Now I shall tell you how he became a sannyasi. One day, when Shankara went to take a bath in the river, a crocodile bit his leg. He yelled for his mother. His mother came running and and was shocked to see her son being bitten. She asked how she can help him. He replied, "Mother, please grant me sannyasa." His mother reluctantly agreed. After she said okay, the crocodile left his leg, and his leg became free. He became a sannyasa. As a sannyasa, he began to travel to find his guru. Finally, he found his guru Govind Bhagavat Pada. After his learning, he began to travel India. Wherever he went, he taught the people about Dharma. He finally finished his mission when he was of the age 32. He went to Kailasha and he died. Hari Om. Thank you.
Well done, Sanvi. So nice.
Thank you, Ji.
It was an amazing speech, Sanvi. Next, we have Vaibhavi on the list.
Hello. Today, I will talk about Saint Basavanna. He was born in 1105 CE, Basava Begiwadi, Bijapur, Karnataka. His father's name is Madrasa and his mother's name is Madalambike. He grew up in Kudala Sangamma and studied there for 12 years. He is married to Gangambike and Neelambike, the daughter of Prime Minister of Bijala, the Kulachuri king. He became the chief minister of the kingdom of Kulachuri. He launched a public institute called Anubhava Mantapa, where people could come and discuss spiritual matters. Unknowingly, it was the world's first parliament. People like Akka Mahadevi, Allama Prabhu, Channa Basavanna, and Haralaya used to be present. He advocated the wearing of Ishtalinga, a necklace with a pendant of Shivalinga. He wrote thousands of vachanas which expressed his views on equality, freedom and liberty. Mahatma Basaveshwara was a 12th century Indian, and one of his famous quotes is Kayakave Kailasha, means work is worship. Basavanna eliminated blind beliefs and superstitions. He disliked the exploitation of uneducated, low-born innocent people by educated high-born Brahmins under the pretext of meaningless rituals. Basavanna denounced penance or atrocious orders to the body to obtain grace of God. Only honest devotion can lead to the grace of God. Basavanna's concept was God is impersonal and supernatural power. God is as large as the universe. His size cannot be measured even in terms of light years. Different religions call God by different names. Basavanna passionately held a conviction of one God. He used to say, "Names many, God is but one." Basavanna questioned which religion does not believe in kindness. Kindness is the base of all religions. He advocated Kayakave Kailasa, work is worship. It is the slogan of Basavanna. He salutes to the devotee who follows an occupation, however humble, the spirit of Kayaka implies that the work should be done with well sense of dedication and hard work. He died in 1167 CE. He has many followers all around the world. Even today, there are many monuments dedicated for him, like Basaveshwar statue at London and much more. Thank you.
Well done, Vaibhavi. You spoke very well on Basavanna. See, work is worship. It applies to all the categories of people, not only spiritual, isn't it? For you students also, if you do it well, if you do your studies well, you will definitely prosper, isn't it? So work is worship is always, you should remember it. Then only you will respect Basavanna, okay, in the real sense. Thank you.
Thank you for the wonderful speech, Vaibhavi. If we follow Basava's principles like this, then surely we will be free of corruption in our country. Next, we have, we finally have Samanvi.
Yes, Akka. Hello, welcome to all Atma Jyotis. My name is Samanvi from Balakrishna. Today, I will tell about the great reformer Basavanna. Basavanna was born in Basavan Bagewadi in Bijapura. His mother name is Madalambika and his father name is Madharasa. He grew up in Kudala Sangama and he studied there for 12 years. He was married to Gangambika and Neelambika. He was the chief minister of the kingdom Kalachuru. He advocated the Ishtalinga, a necklace with a pendant of Shivalinga. He wrote many vachanas that expressed, inspired the equalities, freedom, and liberty. I will tell two of my favorite vachanas. Ullavaru Shivalaya Maduvaru ನಾನೇನು ಮಾಡಲಿ ಬಡವನಯ್ಯ ನನ್ನ ಕಾಲೇ ಕಂಬ ದೇಹವೇ ದೇಗುಲ ಶಿರವೇ ಹೊನ್ನ ಕಳಶವಯ್ಯ ಕೂಡಲ್ ಸಂಗಮ ದೇವ ಕೇಳಯ್ಯ ಸ್ಥಾವರ ಕಿಳಿವುಂಟು ಅಳಿವುಂಟು ಜಂಗಮ ಕಳಿವಿಲ್ಲ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ The rich man builds Shiva temple, but I am a poor man. My legs are pillars, my body is temple, and my head is the golden kalash. Oh, Kulala Sangamadeva, the standing will perish. And the moving will stay on. And the another one is Nada Priya Shivanambaru, Nada Priya Shivanalla. Veda Priya Shivanambaru, Veda Priya Shivanalla. Nadavana Heluva Ravanange Arda Shavaitu Veda Vanodida Brahmanige Tale Hoitu. ನಾದ ಪ್ರಿಯನೂ ಅಲ್ಲ ವೇದ ಪ್ರಿಯನೂ ಅಲ್ಲ ಭಕ್ತ ಪ್ರಿಯ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೂಡಲ ಸಂಗಮ ದೇವ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಸೇ ಶಿವ ಲೈಕ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ನೋ ಹಿ ಡಸಂಟ್ ದೇ ಸೇ ಶಿವ ಲೈಕ್ಸ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಇಟ್ ನೋ ಹಿ ಡಸಂಟ್ ರಾವಣ ಹೂ ಸಾಂಗ್ ನ್ಯೂ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇನ್ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ Brahma, who learned all the Vedas, has to give his head. So, Shiva is not fond of music or not fond of Vedas. He is the Kudala Sangama Deva is fond of the true devotion. There are many monuments all over the country dedicated to him. There are many followers even now who follow Basavanna. His pen name is Koodala Sangamadeva. Hari Om.
Wonderful, wonderful. You brought out the Vachana's explanation. It was splendid, very nicely. Try to read as many Vachanas as possible and try to understand them. They are very beautiful.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Excellent recitation of Basavanna's Vachanas, Samandhi. It was really nice to hear.
Thank you, Akka.
So we have ended with all the speakers on the list. Have I missed anybody?
No, Manyakka.
So I think we've come to an end to today's speaker session. I was really happy seeing you all speak. It was a very nice experience to be a moderator to this session. Thank you, Gayatri ji, and thank you, Katyayani ji, for your valuable time. So we're going to end this session with another prayer. Om Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Shanti 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 Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu
Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Manyaka, can I say something?
Yeah, sure, Harsh. Go ahead.
Though I'm a Jain, I think that the Hinduism is the mother of all nations, of all religions. Because it was the first religion and it gave birth to people who made other religions.
That is really wonderful, Yash, Harsh, because Hinduism is not just a religion, but it is a way of life. Anybody can follow Hinduism. So happy to
hear. And I want to say that even Akbar, who was a Muslim king, he liked Hinduism. So Hinduism is, even I like Hinduism, epics. There are many things in Hinduism which even other people like Christians, Muslims and all like.
Very true. I'm so happy you realized it at such a young age. I'm really happy to see all of you speak such beautiful words.
Katyayani ji, any final words from you before we end this session?
It was a very good session, Gayatri ji. Children spoke very well. I don't have any words.
Yeah, I got to learn so much about Adi Shankaracharya today and Basavanna and about our country. So it's very nice. Thank you, Manya. Thanks a lot. Thanks to all the participants and many thanks to Katyayani ji. On this note, let's end this session, and the next session for Vivekanandas will be happening in this same room. Balakrishnas are free to leave this session. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hari Om.
Hari Om ji.
Hari Om.
Hari Om, Katyayani ji. Hari Om, Akka.
Thank you.
Hari Om.
I can leave now, Gayatri.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hari Om, Gayatri ji. Hari Om, Katyayani ji. Thank you.
Oh, yes, Katyayani ji, you can leave.
Ma'am, can I stay for seeing the Vivekanandas?
Sure. Yeah, anybody who is interested to listen to what Vivekanandas will be speaking, you can stay. The session for Vivekanandas will start after 10 minutes, around 8:05.